PCOS is polycystic ovary syndrome. It's the most common endocrine disorder that a woman goes through and plays a major role in both short and long-term expectation for a person. It's relatively underdiagnosed because we just have to look at 2 out of 3 criteria. So it's not just menstrual irregularities or lack of a period. It's not just acne or hirsutism. And it's not just ultrasound appearance of ovaries with mini cysts. We have to look at the bigger picture and spend more time talking to the ladies, doing a few more tests, but reaching the diagnosis. The main thing is, and the most striking thing is, lack of a period. So when we talk menstrual irregularity, we're not talking about the period that comes every month or two. It more or less when the period doesn't come. I only get my bleed 2 or 3 times a year. That's a striking thing. And when it comes to just spotting, so it's what we call oligohypomenorrhea. The other thing is excessive acne. That's beyond the teenage. Excessive hair growth, and that's beyond the usual female hair pattern distribution. So the woman noted that, yeah, I'm growing a beard or there's a mustache. It wasn't there before. Really unlikely that the woman will have any issue with abdominal pain or discomfort because she's really not ovulating, if anything. PCOS has a huge impact on infertility because by definition, it means that there is abnormal progression of the ovarian follicles. In PCOS, there is arrest of the normal follicular growth. There is disturbance of the normal follicular response to the hormone cycle. There is lack of ovulation or anovulation. There is lack of progesterone production. If the fertility is the main priority for a woman with PCOS, first line of treatment, which has a huge impact, is lifestyle, diet, exercise. Lifestyle improves all of the symptoms of PCOS, including fertility. If the woman loses as less as 5% of her weight, she can go to spontaneous ovulation on her own, and she improves significantly her chances of not only getting pregnant, but sustaining a healthy pregnancy with a good outcome. Lifestyle should never be underestimated. The second step is ovulation induction, which can be done by Clomate, which is a tablet, through a certain regime, or can be done with an FSH injection of a small dose. It depends on the clinical scenario. Both ways, they need lots of support, clinically, psychologically, from the clinician providing the care, from the partner who's going through it with them, from the nursing staff in the clinic, from the reception, even in the doctor's practice where they go to.